which is responsible for cloning base for multiplication. Okay, now what is the meaning of vehicle? It is the vector or it is the DNA which is carrying another DNA. So as per their function only the name has been given. Okay, so what we are studying cloning vector or vehicle DNA. So now let's see what is a vector. What is the definition of vector? Vector are the DNA molecule. Vector, what are vector? Vectors are nothing but the DNA molecule, which is generally present in bacteria or you can say prokaryotic organism. So vectors are the DNA molecule that carry foreign DNA. That carry foreign DNA means it can carry, means if we introduce, if we remove DNA from other organism, we can introduce that DNA. So vectors are nothing but these are the DNA molecule only which can carry, the foreign DNA. When the extra DNA or other DNA is introduced, or the fragment of another DNA is introduced, that is called as vector. Again, I'm repeating, vectors are the DNA molecule that carry foreign DNA. Okay, DNA segment and replicate atomically. They replicate inside the host cell. Suppose this is the E. coli bacteria. Okay, so what is vector? This is suppose vector. So what is vector? Vector is nothing but it is the DNA molecule. Okay, vector is nothing but vector is the DNA molecule which carries a foreign DNA fragment. Okay, suppose this whole part, this much part is a foreign DNA segment. So what is vector? Vector is the DNA molecule which carries a foreign DNA segment and can replicate automatically inside the host cell. Suppose this host cell is E. coli. So automatically when this vector replicates, so this is called as, this is the definition of vector. Again, I'm repeating, what is vector? Vector is nothing but it is a DNA molecule which carry foreign DNA segment, and can replicate automatically inside the host cell. So this is nothing but vector. Now, I will take few examples of vector. Vector plasmids can be vector. Bacteriophage means viruses can be vector. BAC means bacterial artificial chromosome can be vector. YAC means yeast artificial chromosome. MAC means mammalian artificial chromosome. These are few I have given the examples of vector. What is vector? Vector is nothing but it is a DNA molecule which carry foreign DNA fragment or a segment and it can replicate inside the host cell. Few examples are there for vector. It can be plasmid, it can be bacteriophage, it can be BAC means bacterial artificial chromosome, it can be YAC means yeast artificial chromosome, it can be MAC means mammalian artificial chromosome. Okay, many vectors are there, but generally scientists are commonly using plasmids and bacteriophage only. Many vectors are there, but scientists are using generally this plasmids and bacteriophage. Now from plasmids also, they are generally using this PBR-322. PBR, here B stands for plasmid, BR stands for the name of scientist, and this is nothing but the number. Okay, PUC again plasmid, UC is name of the scientist. Here PI plasmid. So these are the three plasmids which are usually used by the scientist. Now coming to bacteriophage. Two bacteriophages or viruses generally scientists are using for their experiment. One is lambda phage and another one is M30 phage. Now coming to last point, there are two types of vectors. Vectors are of two types. First type of vector is called as expression vector and another is called as cloning vector. Now what is the meaning of expression vector and cloning vector? Suppose we did RDNA technology. Now this vector is producing when we did the cloning. Suppose we have 100 copies of this bacteria and everywhere the vector is responsible for the production of certain product. Suppose it is producing insulin. Okay, means what it is doing? It is expressing, it is doing some work, it is producing insulin, it is producing antibodies, it is producing vaccine. So that type of vector is called as expression vector. Expression vector means when we collect some product from this vector, That type of vector is called as expression vector. Now another type is cloning vector. Cloning vector means what? See, everywhere this vector will be there. Okay. And now we are not related, we are not concerned with the product. We want the gene, that segment only for us, for desired segment only. Then what we are doing? Suppose this vector is there, this is containing the desired gene or the gene of interest, means the gene which we want. Okay, suppose 100 bacteria are there in all the E. coli, in all the bacteria, vector will be there. All vector will carry the vector. All bacteria will carry the vector. Okay, so what we are doing here? We are just breaking this bacteria. We are tearing this bacteria. We are removing this vector from this bacteria, and we are cutting the gene of our interest only. So at a time we are getting 100 segment of desired gene, the gene which we want. So that type of vector which is giving us the type of desired gene, that is called as cloning vector. Okay, so here we are studying cloning vector. Cloning vector is also called as vehicle DNA. What is vector? Vector is nothing but it is a DNA molecule which contains foreign DNA segment, and it replicates inside the host cell or bacterial cell. There are many types of, few examples I have given. One is plasmid, bacteriophages, BAC, YAC, MSC. These are nothing but the examples of vectors. Now, the most commonly used vectors by the scientists are generally plasmids and bacteriophages only. They are rarely using this type of vectors. Now, vectors are of two types. One is called as expression vector, another one is called as cloning vector. Expression vector means a vector which is responsible for the collection which gives the product, like vaccine, insulin, antibiotics, et al. That is called as expression vector. The vector which is used to collect the desired segment of interest or gene of interest, that is called as cloning vector. Now we have to study characters of vectors. Okay, now these many characters should be there in the vector. So let's see about the characters. What type of characters should be there in the vector? First character is, vector should have ability to replicate independently. They should have ability, they should have capacity to replicate automatically, independently, without anybody's support. Okay, now what is the benefit of this? Why they should be replicated independently? See, as they replicate, whatever the gene, desired gene or gene of interest which we have introduced in that vector will also replicate. Means in a short period of time, as soon as the replicate will multiply or it will replicate, we will also get maximum number of copies of gene of interest. Okay, so this quality should vector should have, that it should replicate automatically or independently. Then next one is, it should be able to easily introduce inside the host. Okay, means suppose this is the bacterial cell and now this is the vector. Okay, now this is the vector. This vector should have capacity. Sometimes what happens, it should not enter inside the host cell only. So we want that type of vector which should be able to easily introduce inside the host cell. They should be the second quality of the vector. First quality means they should have the capability to replicate independently. As soon as they will replicate, the more they replicate, more we will get the desired gene. Okay. Second quality of vector is, they should get introduced inside the, they should easily get introduced inside the host cell. Coming to third character, they must have a marker gene. In this vector DNA, they must have marker gene. Now, what is the use of this marker gene? Marker gene are nothing but they are providing antibiotic resistance. Means, once the marker gene is present in the vector, no antibiotic can cause any type of harm to this bacteria. Okay, so this is the third quality of vector. Vector should have this marker genes which is acting as an antibiotic resistance. Once the marker gene is there, bacteria will be protected from the antibiotics. Then, they should have control element inside this vector. As they have to replicate, they should have these specific sites. For example, they should have promoter site, they should have operator site, and they should have ribosomal binding site. These sites should be there in the vector. So these are the four characters which should be there in the vector. Again, I'm repeating, we are setting the characteristics which should be there in the vector. First one is the vector should replicate independently. Second one is it should be easily introduced inside the host cell. Third, it should have marker gene which provides antibiotic resistance to bacteria. And it should have the control elements like promoter gene or promoter site, operator site and ribosomal binding site. But what was the problem? But the natural plasmids, many natural plasmids are there, but these natural plasmids do not contain all type of characters. Scientists found that these natural plasmids are, they do not have all the characters, one or the other character is missing. Generally they found that this character is not there, presence of marker gene is not there in the plasmid. So what they did, they made artificial, they constructed artificial vector. Okay, what they did here, now they found that these type of vectors generally do not have this marker gene. So how they prepared? They prepared artificial plasmid by introducing this marker gene which provides antibiotic resistance. Okay, in this way many artificial vector they have produced or introduced. Now for your example, I am giving you PBR322, PBR320, ACYC177. These are few vectors which are produced by the scientists. But out of these three, this PBR322, which is introduced by the scientist, which is constructed by the scientist, is generally used in rDNA technology. Okay, so we are studying here about vector. Vector should have these four qualities, four characteristics should be there in the vector. But scientists found that many vectors do not have all the characters. So specifically they found that the vectors do not have this marker gene. So they constructed artificial vector. In artificial vector, they introduce the marker gene so that bacteria will be antibiotic resistant. Okay, and they constructed three vectors. Out of these three vectors, this PBR322 is mostly used by the scientists during rDNA technology. So here we have completed about vector.